simple, or so you think. Just try to focus. Calm your racing heart while being pulled behind a boat barefoot at upwards of 50 miles an hour. The honor and prestige of a world championship barefoot title is on the line. So the best in the extreme sport of barefooting's three disciplines, slalom, trick, and jump, will throw caution to the wind and put it on the edge in order to defeat the other top competitors from around the globe as 15 countries fly their flags with honor. To be the best, you have to beat the best. It's the dynamic action of barefoot. The 2006 World Barefoot Water Ski Championships up next, only on television's new wave, Water Channel. Hundreds of the best barefoot water skiers from around the world put in endless hours of practice in order to make it through their regional championships, to get to the national championships, and hopefully qualify for this, the prestigious World Championships. Hello everyone, I'm Heather Adams. Joining me is two-time national open champion Mike Salber. Mike, what do we have on tap today?
Well, they've hammered it all out. They've skied their best, and now we've narrowed it down to the top five finalists in each division. The best of the best in the three divisions are going to be skiing here in the finals, and that's what's in store for us today.
Two names that's on everyone's lips already, Heinrich Sam from the Republic of South Africa and Ashley Stebbings of Australia, but they're only two of the many that we need to keep our eyes on.
Well, definitely Heinrich Sam and Ashley Stebbings, the big guns in the junior boys and the junior girls division. But we also have the senior men and the senior women. In the senior women's division, we'll see Jody Sherwood, Andrea Eggert, Sherry Morris. Some great skiers in that senior women's division. The three top qualifiers in the senior men's division, Averett Artson, Mike Salber, myself, and John Stecklenburg. Then we have the open women's division with Rachel Norman and also Jody Sherwood in that division. Then the best of the best are here, the big guns. Keith St. Ange, Andre Davilliers, David Small, Patrick Werner, just to name a few. They're the best. They've skied fantastically throughout the week in all the qualifying rounds. We might be seeing a world record sometime this week.
And we have three different divisions that we have an opportunity to see that in. Slalom, trick, and jump. Break that down for us. Let us know what we're expecting.
The slalom division is when the skiers cross the wake as many times as they can. They'll have two 15-second passes to do just that. Each time they ski, they'll have to ski across the wake on one foot. If they ski across the wake on one foot, they'll receive 1 point. Then if they get to the end of that 15-second pass, they'll have another 15-second pass, but this time they'll have to go backwards. Then we move on to the trick division. You'll see surface turns where the skiers ski on that small surface of their barefoot. They'll turn to the back, they'll turn to the front. Then they turn 360 and all the way up to 720-degree turns, and big point values, all the way up to 1,000 points for some of those 720-degree turns. And then we'll see flips, which are big points. Then last but not least, the most extreme of the barefoot water skiing is the barefoot water ski jumping. The skiers will come into the ramp at speeds up to 45 miles per hour. They'll hit a ramp that's 7 feet long, 18 inches high off the water, and propel themselves hopefully somewhere out towards that world record of 27.4 meters or somewhere around 90 feet.
They're going to go full throttle here on Lake Silverado from Adna, Washington, when Water Channel coverage of the 2006 Barefoot World Water Ski Championships returns.
Inside the Bay, brought to you by Bay of Quinte Tourism.
Doug Stevenson here for Inside the Bay. I'm at Dream Lake. And it is a dream. We're just north of Napanee, home of the 2016 National Barefoot Water Ski Championships. We're also going to be hosting the World Championships here shortly. We're going to be talking with some of the people involved with that championship. You know, just behind us is this man-made lake, so we're going to talk to the owners. Also talk to some of our MP, our MPP, and some of the skiers themselves, the organizers. So stay tuned. with Alan Moyne's chair of the 2018 World Organizing Committee. You know, we were just talking off camera. This is an amazing media event. And so if this event is any indication of what 2018 is going to be like, you must be pretty excited.
We are very excited. This is, I've been personally to the World Championships in several locations around the world.
Yeah.
And we are very excited to bring them here. We now have a site. Well, since we got hooked up with Dwight here, we have a site that is second to none, and we now have the opportunity. The desire has been there to bring it to Canada. The problem, the biggest issue is always having a site that is suitable, and we've got one here, and it will be awesome because Dwight will do what it takes to make it happen.
Welcome back to Water Channel coverage of the 2006 Barefoot Water Ski World Championships from Adna, Washington. First up, we have the Junior Boys World Slalom Division. Chris Morrison, Brody Benoist, Zane DeVilliers, and Billy Benoist, Heinrich Sam, top seed, going last in this event. Zane DeVilliers on the water right now, 15.2 from round one and a 16.4 from round two. He's looking to better that right now.
Heather, watch to see Zane DeVilliers pick up that foot early before he crosses that wake. He'll receive the maximum point value if he does that. If he touches down anywhere in that white wash, then he'll lose point value and get deducted. But Zane looks like he's all high and clean, looks very good. The timer expires. He does a back to front. Now he'll ski to the end of the course.
Scored a 16.8 there. He got third in the slalom last year. Heinrich Sam on the water now from the Republic of South Africa. A 17.2 in round one and 17.7 in round two. Great job so far.
Heinrich
here.
Sam, a very accomplished young front slalom skier. Watch as he holds the foot high. He whips that leg out to get himself to transition from one crossing to the next. His time expires. A very fast pace for young Heinrich Sam from the Republic of South Africa.
17.7 is his final score there. Next up, the Junior Boys Trick Division, Brody Benoist, Zane DeVilliers, Ben Harris, Billy Benoist, and Heinrich Sam, the top seed. Let's see the top two runs. First one from Heinrich Sam, a score of 95.80 in the first round. That was good enough that he didn't have to ski in the second round of this event.
95.80 is a miraculous score for Heinrich Sam. Watch as he puts the rope on his foot and does a toe back, toe front, all these nice and clean, feet to feet. Now he does the back to front, the front to back, loses the handle a little bit, back to front to back again. Now he'll do the 360 turn, the reverse 360 turn, and a quick side slide. That's all his run.
Scored him a 74.30. Up next is Billy Benoist from the US of A. Round one scored a 4,700 and round two 5,710. Looking to do much better here so he can take home the championship.
Watch how light Billy Benoist skis on his feet. He's backwards now. He does the back to back 360, the reverse back to back 360. Now back to front 540. Now two 360s front to front, then he'll do the four tick-tock turns to the front. Does a wave so he can do the seven to the front. A great run from young Billy Benoist.
And a score of 80-60. Next up, Junior Boys Jump Division, Garth Stridham, Ryan Groen, Ben Harris, Chris Morrison, and Heinrich Sam, the two top seeds in this division. Chris Morrison with an 18.9 meter best jump in rounds one and two. What's he looking to do here?
Well, Chris, a very popular and personable young man on the water in the junior division. He looks like he leaves the ramp a little bit early, but still gets up and over, lands, skis away.
18.8 meters is his final best for round three. Up next, Heinrich Sam from the Republic of South Africa with a 20.4 meter best.
Watch Heinrich Sam as he gets full extension off that ramp. Lands very smooth, very clean. That's a great jump for Heinrich Sam.
With a score of 21.8 meters in the final round. Judges tally up the scores for the junior boys. Right now, junior girls, that's the top five seeds for the junior girls jump division. Kelly O'Donnell, Shannon Heller, Emily Goldie, Elaine Heller, and Ashley Stebbings. We'll take a look at the top two jumps from Elaine Heller and Ashley Stebbings. Best jump from round two is 11.7 meters.
Well, Elaine Heller has been skiing brilliantly all week. Now she'll jump in that traditional style. She's up and over. She skis away somewhere out there at 10, 11, 12 meters.
11.5 meters is her final score for round three. Up now, Ashley Stebbings from Australia. Her best jump in this competition, a 13.4 in round one.
She's a past world champion. She knows what to do. She's up and over. A big jump again for Ashley Stebbings.
12.9 meters, her final score. Junior girls trick division hitting the water next. Sarah Lebegang, Emily Goldie, Laura Dickers, Elaine Heller, and Ashley Stebbings, the top five seeds. Emily Goldie's best score in round one, a 1600, 1570 in round two. What's she looking to do here?
Well, she starts off with the rope on her foot. That's a toe-up start. That's worth 450 points. Now she'll get set. She puts her foot in the rope. There's another 100 points. Now the reverse toe hold. That's 200 more points. She does a tumble turn to one foot. That's another 100. And then the reverse tumble. That's another 100. Now she'll do a 180 to 1, 180 to 1. Wave, wave, reverse. She's happy. She's excited.
Score of 21.60 for Emily Goldie. Up next, Ashley Stebbings. We've seen so many great things from her already. A 20.50 score in round one and a 2200 in round two.
Watch how fast she does all these tricks. Now she's on the water. She's going to load up. She's going to go for the neck, the 1 foot. Now the neck, 1 foot, 1 foot reverse. Now she'll put that in her teeth, 1 foot, 1 foot reverse while holding on with her teeth. Now she goes with the two toe holds. A tumble to one, the reverse 360 tumble up to two, but wave, wave, and a hop.
And a final score of 21.90 for Ashley Stebbings in the junior girls trick division. Taking the gold from the Republic of South Africa is Heinrich Sam in the slalom division with a score of 17.7. In the trick division, it was Billy Benoist taking the gold home for the United States of America with a final score of 8,060 points. Heinrich Sam on the podium once again, taking the gold home, this time in the jump division with a final best of 21.8 meters.
Everyone knows that I'm pretty quiet, and usually I don't smile when I get medals, but I was really, really happy.
So the overall winner, the world champion in the boys division with 3,000 points, Heinrich Sam.
In the junior girls slalom division, Elaine Heller taking the gold with a final score of 14. And in the trick division, Ashley Stebbings, no surprise here, with a score of 21.90, that she's taking home the gold back with her to Australia. And in the jump division, Ashley once again on the top of the podium, 12.9 meter jump in the final round won her the gold medal.
I'm representing my country and I'm just proud to be part of the team.
So your overall world champion in the junior girls division, Ashley Stebbings, with 2,928 points.
Coming up, the best senior barefooters from around the world take on the waters here at Lake Silverado on Water Channel.
Inside the Bay, brought to you by Bay of Quinte Tourism.
Now I'm here with Dwight, who's the owner of this beautiful property called Dream Lake. Yep. What's the motivation to call it Dream Lake?
25 years of dreaming, yeah, and doing things that people think you couldn't do and just getting it done, but yeah, that's about it.
It's been really neat talking to the Moines family as they put the committee together, put the bid together, working closely with you. And obviously, you know, you're hosting the 2016 Nationals here this weekend. You've had other big events here throughout the years.
Oh, yeah.
It's really neat to hear how committed and motivated you are, and you're not even really part of the water ski community. So where's that come from?
That comes from working hard and paying it forward, I guess you'd say.
Yeah.
You know, we're all here just a short time, so you try to do as much as you can when you're here, and when you have something as nice as this is, it's nice to share it with people.
Welcome back to Water Channel coverage of the 2006 Barefoot Water Ski World Championships. Right here, the boat parade on that beautiful Sanger with the top five in the men's jump event. Mike Salbert, Gordy Croutot, Warren Wark, John Stecklenberg, and Evert Artson. Take a look at the top two jumps first from Mike Salbert. His best jump from the first two rounds in 18.7 meters.
Well, here in the finals, Heather, this isn't the best jump I'd ever had, but I'm really glad to be here, glad to get a silver medal here. I'd just like to say thanks to barefootcentral.com for supporting me so much for the last 4 years.
In 19.3 meters for Mike in the final round. Up next was John Stecklenburg. Best jump in the first two rounds was a 20 meters.
John Stecklenburg, a fierce competitor in the senior men's division. He's a prior champion, lands a great big jump there. John Stecklenburg wins that competition.
With a 21.1 meter jump. Up next is the senior men's slalom division, Gordy Croteau, Brad Pegg, Jerry Knoyer, Mike Salber once again, and John Stecklenburg. Brad Pegg out on the water, one of the best runs we saw in slalom. His round one score was a 15.3 and 15.8 from round two.
Brad Pegg, a tall drink of water. He's well over 6 foot five. He's got that long stride, sticks it out over the water, a very fast pace. He's been a dear friend of mine since the late 70s. Brad Pegg, one of the guys who got me into barefoot water skiing.
He takes a 15.3 in this final round. Gordy Croteau of Canada with a back deep water start. 14.2 was his first round score and a 15.7 in round two.
You know what was interesting about Gordy Croteau? I heard him on the dock. He called well over 50 miles an hour. Now backwards, he comes into the course at a very fast pace, all the feet high and clean as he crosses that wake on one foot. Gordy Croteau skiing very, very well right here. The time goes off. Gordy's going to be happy with that run.
15.8. The men's trick division on the water next with Brian Heaney, Cameron Smith, Avert Artson, John Stecklenburg, and once again, Mike Salber, one of the top seeds. Brian Heaney with a first round score of 35.30 and a second round score of 2,800 on the water for trick.
Brian Heaney, the chairman of the board of the Barefoot Water Ski Association here in America. He starts off with in the loaded position with 2 1-foots. Now he does the line front, completely feet to feet. Now he does the 1 foot front to back, very clean. The judges will like that, Heather. Now he does the back to front. Now he does the 360 front to front, butts it out a little bit. Time expires. Brian Heaney skiing well here at the 2006 Worlds.
Earning a score of 31.50. Next on the water, John Stecklenburg with a round one score of 43.30 and a round two score of 40.80.
John Stecklenburg with a very unique start here. That's a back tumble up to, will he do it on two? He does it to 2 feet. Extra credit if you do it on 1 foot, but now John comes into the course backwards. He does a position turn to the front. Now watch as he cuts over to the side. He's going to set up here for a wake flip. He goes over the wake, does a flip, lands that flip very good. Now the surface flip, there's 1,100 points just for those two tricks. He does the front to back, the back to front, the reverse front to back, the reverse back to front. Now we'll look and see he does a 1 foot back to front. As time expires, John Stecklenburg skiing very well.
That run got him a 36.30. Up next, the women's senior jump division with Jody Sherwood, Andrea Eggert, and Sherry Morse. Andrea Eggert on the water for her jump, a round one best of 9.1 meters.
Andrea Eggert now, she's in the curl. Now watch as she cuts out into that flat water. She's going over the face of the jump. Her feet slide out. She lands hard on the bum, but still skis it away.
8.7 meter jump in round three for Andrea. Jody Sherwood up next with a best jump here at this event of 8.7 meters.
This probably isn't Jody's favorite event, but a great, strong, clean jump for Jody. She throws the handle. She knows what she needs to do. Jody Sherwood, USA.
Matched her best of an 8.7 meter jump. Up next, the senior women's trick division. Sherry Morse, Teresa Hoffman, Kay Weiser, Andrea Eggert, and Jody Sherwood, all from the United States. Andrea Eggert on the water first with a round one best of 1880 and a round two of 1800 points.
Andrea Eggert, one of my fellow Team USA teammates on the senior team. Now she goes into her trick run. She's done with her 1 foot toe holds and now her tumble turns. She stands them up cleanly on 1 foot. Now the 180, watch as she stands up on 1 foot. She does a 1 foot, 1 foot wave as time expires. Andrea Eggert from Team USA.
She matches her round two score of 1,800. Jody Sherwood on the water now, hoping for a strong showing just as she did in the first two rounds with her best score of 2,180 in round two.
Jody Sherwood comes in once again with that strong toe-up start. She goes directly into her tumble turns. Jody Sherwood has skied just brilliantly all week. Now she's here in the finals. She finishes off with a toe reverse. 1 foot, 1 foot hop, wave as time expires. Jody Sherwood would be extremely happy with that, Heather.
A 23.60 for round three. In the senior men's jump division, John Stecklenburg takes home the gold after a 21.1 meter jump. In the slalom division for the senior men, Gordy Croteau takes home the gold with a 15.8. John Stecklenburg on the top of the podium once again, this time for the trick division in senior men's. A 36.30 won him the gold.
I mean, I was happy with my jumps because I didn't jump very well in the preliminary rounds, and I put it together a little bit more in the semis and in the final.
That's probably the most stress I had all week, was waiting for to see how the results would turn out.
So the overall world champion in the senior men's division, John Stecklenburg, with 2,941 points.
In the senior women's jump division, Jody Sherwood dominated and took home the gold after an 8.7 meter best in round three. Jody Sherwood up on top of the standings once again, 13 points won her the slalom division. Jody Sherwood just dominating at this year's Worlds, a 23.60 won her the gold in the trick division.
Because I knew I'd skied a personal best, and that's really all I'm here, you know, I want to ski my best and wherever that lands me. If I win, I win, that's great. If I don't, it's okay. I just want to ski my best.
So in the senior women's division, your world overall champion, Jody Sherwood, with 2,925 points.
Up next, Svenja Hempelman and the rest of the Open Women competitors hit the water here at Lake Silverado for the 2006 Barefoot Water Ski World Championships on Water Channel.
Brian is, he's been who I've been talking to in building my Sanger boat, and we're fixing to
try it out,
do the unveiling and the whole tutorial, correct?
The tutorial.
Wow, look at this bad boy.
It's got way more than that. Wait until you see some of the
green. God, it's gorgeous.
We don't do this for anybody. This is metallic gel coat.
I love it. It's gorgeous. How badass is this? That is crazy. This is crazy. Look at this, man. How about that? You about to cry, Monica?
Yeah.
That is awesome. Look at there. Oh, look at there. Y'all are killing me. What's up, y'all? I'm on my boat. It's my boat. And I got my honey bunny here. We're going on the California Delta, first time.
Now I'm sitting pretty in suntan. City got the best view in the world. Spending my days catching these rays, watching coconut covered girls. Yeah, I'm sitting pretty in suntan city with a cold one in my hand. Yeah.
All right, signing off from the California Delta.
Sanger boat country.
There were four other singers at the
launch ramp.
So
we're good.
These guys got me dialed in. We're ready to wakeboard, surf, ski.
Tear up the Tennessee water.
That's it. Thank you, Singer Boats. Peace out.
Right here in Suntan City.
Inside the Bay, brought to you by Bay of Quinte Tourism.
All right, I'm with MPP Todd Smith, MP Neil Ellis.
two guys who have been really instrumental parts of this community, Bay Quinte region, for a long time now. I thought you said something very interesting. You said, you know, volunteers put the unity in community. Here we are. This is the site of the 2016 Nationals this weekend, but also the 2018 World Championships. So how important is it to have that community rallying around something like this?
Definitely, and it's all the background work behind these events, not only the volunteers, but the sponsors. And you see the group of sponsors that have jumped aboard. And in this area, in Eastern Ontario, I think with volunteers and sponsors, we probably have the best group.
This stuff's huge for the region. And you know, again, from being on the radio, people talk about it. It's not just gonna be here.
Yeah.
This is a world championship we're bringing in. So this is international media. So, you know, how do you see this being beneficial to the region in terms of that scope?
Oh, it puts us on the map, right? It puts Bay of Quinte region on the map, it puts Belleville on the map. This one obviously puts the Napanee area on the map. You know, we've been fortunate to host a couple of world championships over the last little while. We had the World Floorball Championships here. It's gonna be great. I guess they've got competitors coming from 12 different countries for the Worlds. We've got the Nationals here this weekend, and it's a great sport. I mean, it's one that you probably have to be a little bit crazy to do, but it looks like a lot of fun and a lot of really neat tricks. And so we've got a local person, obviously, who's had great success on the world stage as well, and Becky Moynes. So wish her the best here. And of course, you know, barring any catastrophe, she'll be performing as well for Canada in 2018.
Mean to be part of this team that's bringing the worlds to the region?
It's absolutely amazing. I mean, we've got a really good group of barefooters in Ontario that have basically, like, we've all adopted each other's family, and it's just such a tight-knit group that we all work together and thrive off each other. And it's awesome to be able to put on the Nationals and have people from down under come and ski and want to ski Nationals, but to put on worlds is going to be even bigger, better, and we're really looking forward to it. Super pumped. So.
Welcome back to Water Channel coverage of the 2006 Barefoot Water Ski World Championships from Adna, Washington. There's the boat parade for the open women's jump event. Nicole Monroe, Svenja Hempelman, Rachel Normand, Emily Goldie, and Ashley Stebbings.
It was pretty exciting. I didn't come out. I only come out to, like, set new PBs for myself.
Svenja Hempelman of Germany, her round one best jump of 10.8 meters matched in round two.
Well, we look to see Svenja. She stands up behind that gecko boat. She's out into the curl, probably going to ski over that ramp somewhere in the 40, 41 mile an hour range. The water is a little bit chippy. She pulls out. Things looking good right here. She's a little bit heavy on that left foot. That's what causes it to come up in the air, but nevertheless, she lands that jump, Heather.
10.9 meter jump was her best in round three. Up now, Nicole Monroe from United States of America. Her round one best jump was 9.7 meters, 10.2 meters in round two.
Nicole Monroe just recently married. Now her husband watches her on the shore banks. She's up and over that jump, skis away very clean, and Nicole Monroe happy with that jump.
A 10.8 meter for Nicole. Up now, Emily Goldie of Great Britain, 11.6 meters, her best jump from round one, 10.7 meters from round two.
Emily Goldie now out into the flat water. She'll edge back into the curl, set herself up. Mom Sue and Daddy and in the crowd watching their 17-year-old daughter compete as she comes into the ramp. Her feet slide up and over, very smooth, nice landing, Emily Goldie.
11.8 meters in round three. Up next, Rachel Normand from the United States of America. 11.5 meters was her best jump in round one, besting that by 11.6 in round two.
The green gecko boat accelerates up to speed, somewhere probably in the neighborhood of 42 miles an hour. I got to practice with Rachel before the tournament. She's skiing very well. Watch her feet, nice and even, a little bit heavy on the left foot, but lands it nevertheless, a good jump.
13.5 meters, the best in round three. Ashley Stebbings of Australia on the water again. 11.8 meters was her best jump from round one, 12.9 meters best in round two.
Ashley now coming into the face of that jump, she's got the capability of going up where somewhere around that 14-meter mark. She comes into the ramp, she's up and over, a little bit heavy on the right foot, but she likes the jump.
12.5 meters for Ashley Stebbings. Banana George Blair contributes so much to this sport. He's been watching the jump event, just enjoying the festivities here at the 2006 Worlds.
Heather, he's always a big attraction. The kids get autographs signed from him. He's just a great personality of our sport.
The running order for the Open Women's Slalom event, Emily Goldie, Elaine Heller, Ashley Stebbings, Narissa Wright, and Rachel Norman.
I'm seated second in both events, so I'm feeling confident.
Emily Goldie on the water now from Great Britain. A round one score of 10.6. Round two brought her a 12.8.
Emily Goldie now edging out into the curl. She'll stand up. Watch for her to test that water with that 1 foot before she gets started. Now look for her to go across that wake and cross outside the wake with on 1 foot. Every time she crosses on 1 foot, she will receive a point. Everything looks high and clean, nothing for the judges to cut her on. Emily Goldie skiing very good here at the World 2006 Water Ski Championships throughout the week. Time expires, she does very well.
A 13 for Emily Goldie in round three. Elaine Heller of the United States, barefooting for 7 years now, got a score of 12.2 in round one and 12.8 in round two.
Well, Elaine Heller has taken women's barefooting by storm here in the United States. She comes from a family that are dairy farmers. Her dad, Blake, and her mom, Janelle, have put in a lake. They call it the Blue Moo out in Wisconsin. Now we watch as Elaine Heller skis. She touches down there a little early. She'll receive a slight deduction, but nevertheless, she takes up where she left off. Doesn't bobble, doesn't falter, and she's skiing across all the rest, her high and clean, as time runs out for her run.
12.4, the round three score for Elaine Heller. Narissa Wright of Australia on the water next. Round one score of 13.3 and round two of impressive 14.2.
Heather, I got to meet Narissa Wright at the last World Barefoot Water Ski Championships. She's a very personable young lady, very popular amongst the junior skiers. Now she's on the water. She starts on the passenger side, lifts up that 1 foot as time will start. Now she's across on her second crossing. Looks like she may have touched down early there. We'll have to see what the judges say, but still very strong skiing from Narissa Wright from Australia. As time is just about to expire, she's still going strong. Time does expire as we hear the horn.
13.5 score in round three. Rachel Norman of the United States up now. 15.2 from round one and a 14.9 in round two.
Well, Rachel Norman has just been a dominator from the get-go. She skis very well. She skied very well at Nationals. She won the Nationals. Now she's here at the Worlds, a big team skier for the United States. As she crosses the wake, the foot is high and clean, starts out way past the bubbles, way out into the curl. Everything looks smooth and clean. Up, she touches down a little bit early there. She'll get a slight deduction, a half-point deduction, but the time expires. Rachel Norman from USA.
13.1, possibly not the score she was looking for. Ashley Stebbings on the water now for the women's open event. A 13.2 round one score and 10.4 from round two.
As I said before, Ashley Stebbings is the junior girls world champion from the previous Worlds. Now she comes into the course backwards. We'll look for her to go on 1 foot all the way across that wake. The first one complete, very good, very strong. This is the first backwards run we've seen from the women. Look how she negotiates through that wake, has a little bobble there, her shoulders get a little back, but she still will score the crossing. Up a little bit late there, but nevertheless, I think that the judges will credit all those, Heather.
13 in round three for Ashley Stebbings. Stacy Green on the dock there from Australia with some last minute prep work. We'll be back with more action from the 2006 Barefoot Water Ski World Championships right here on Water Channel.
Hi, we're here showing our Enmar motors that we're exclusively using today in all the production of Sanger boats. Enmar's been in business for almost as long as Sanger boats have been in business. They've got servicing dealers all over the country, and we're proud to have them as our exclusive power. We have a 5.7 335 horsepower motor. We have a 5.7 358 horsepower motor, the MCX. We have a 6 liter engine that's a 409 horsepower. Enmar builds all their exhaust manifolds in-house. They've got catalyzed exhaust, all of them, which is putting out about 25% of the CO emissions that we were putting out in the standard motors without cat exhaust. So for more details, you can go to our website and look at the specs on each one of these engines, and they are great performing motors, and we're happy to have them.
Okay, so we got some footage of you, Brem, doing a jump out on Dream Lake. So tell me about what you were doing earlier.
We were doing a little jump demo, and you know, conditions are a little chippier than ideal this morning, but it's a lot of fun. You hit the ramp and go flying in the air and see if you can go further than your buddy.
And speaking of further than your buddy, you went further than a lot of buddies because you just broke a record.
Yeah, actually, I spent some time in Florida earlier in the summer and went to their Southern Regional Tournament and ended up jumping 26 meters. So the previous record was 25.4 meters, so got a little further than.
And we're talking what type of record here?
It's a distance jump record, right? And it was set, I believe, in 99. So it's been a long-standing record. And
welcome back to Water Channel and coverage of the 2006 Barefoot Water Ski World Championships, where in between the competition, we're having fun with a snowmobile pulling a competitor across the lake. The running order for the Open Women's Trick Division: Stacy Green, Jody Sherwood, Ashley Stebbings, Laura Swede, and Rachel Norman.
Train really hard and then kind of let up at the end. That's the way I do it.
Stacy Green of Australia on the water first.
Stacy Green elects to come into the course backwards. She stands up the back deep start. Now she's going to start the clock with her first trick. She'll have 15 seconds to put all her tricks on the water. Time starts now. She lifts that 1 foot. She does the 1 foot, 1 foot reverse. Now she goes to the back toe hold. Now she does the reverse back toe hold. A back surface hop. Look for her to go to the front position with a back to front. That's a big trick in the ladies division. Now she does a tumble turn 360 to 1 foot as time expires. Stacy Green from Australia.
Round three score of 2,030 points for Stacy. Up next, Jody Sherwood from the United States of America. A round one score of 2,170. Round two, only a 1,790. Definitely looking to do better here.
Well, Jody dominated the senior women's division. Now she's out in the water. She'll give a little wave to the driver to tell that driver to bring that boat up to speed so she can stand up that front toe up start. Now she'll go directly into her 360 tumble turn to one. Now the reverse 360 tumble turn to one. Now the 180 tumble turn to one. The reverse 180 tumble turn stands it up on 1 foot and goes right into the toe hold. Now the reverse toe hold. 1 foot, 1 foot, reverse, wave, wave as time expires for Jody Sherwood from the United States.
Score of 23.50. Ashley Stebbings of Australia on the water, already making such a strong showing here at the Worlds. Round one saw a 21.70 and round two a 22.40.
Well, she's already got an overall world championship in the junior girls division. Now she's on the water in the open women's division, where now she stands up that toe-up start, 400 points right off the bat. She loads up for the neck and teeth tricks. Starts off immediately with 1 foot, 1 foot reverse, goes into the neck hold, 1 foot, 1 foot reverse, and the teeth hold, 1 foot, 1 foot reverse, goes right into the toe holds, both toe holds. Now she goes into the tumble turns, tumble 360. Both she will elect to stand up on 2 feet, wave, wave, reverse, sit down, stand up as time expires.
21.60 in round three for Ashley Stebbings. Up next, it's Laura Swede of the United States. She got a 22.40 in rounds one and two.
Well, Laura Swede, an independent skier from the United States, she's a very strong trick skier. This is her forte. Watch as she stands up that toe up. She just powers it up, a very strong young lady from the United States. She'll load up for the teeth hold. She does a surface hop to begin. She does the 1 foot and 1 foot in the teeth hold. Now she does the 360 tumble turn to one. Now the reverse 360 tumble turn to one. The 180 tumble turn to one does ski up on the wake a little bit, but regains composure, does the reverse wave wave as she finishes out.
Score of 21.70 for Laura. Rachel Norman, a United States favorite here at the Worlds. Round one saw her with a score of 25.30 and round two 26.80. Very strong.
Rachel's first pass as she comes into the course, this will be a back deep start. So she's up and out into that curl. Watch as time starts when she does that first trick. Right there, time starts. She'll have 15 seconds now. She does two back 1 foots, a surface hop, and the two back toe holds. Releases the hands cleanly for the judges. Watch for the back to front now. She does the back to front. It's clean. It's feet to feet. Now the front to back. That's big points for Rachel Norman. Now the reverse back to front. As time expires, Rachel Norman has a great run here.
And a score of 21-70. On the water again, Laura Sweet of the United States. We do have a tie for second place between her and Rachel Norman, also from the U.S.
So when we have a tie, what do we have to do? We have to send both competitors back out for a runoff. Now this is Laura Sweet. She stands the toe up, shows the hands to the judges. High and clean, she will receive points for that start. Right there, she's into the teeth hold. 1 foot, 1 foot reverse. Goes to a 360 tumble turn to 1 foot. Now the reverse 360 tumble turn to 1 foot. Now the 180 stands up on 1 foot. Now the reverse 180. Will she stand up? Yes, on 1 foot. One foot reverse. Wave, wave, time expires. A great run for Laura Swede. Now the pressure is on Rachel Norman, Heather.
Rachel has 17 years of barefooting behind her. Great scores throughout this competition. But what's going through her head right now after seeing Laura's run?
Well, she's seen Laura's run. Her and her coach on the dock have probably added up Laura's scores. She knows what she has to do. So now she just has to go out there and perform. She starts right off immediately with the back surface hop, goes into the back toe hold, now the reverse back toe hold. Now watch for that back to front. Back to front, very clean, very good for Rachel. Now the front to back, ooh, very strong, very feet to feet, and time expires as she does the back to front. It looks good to me, Heather. I think that she's done it. I think that she'll get that silver medal.
We'll have to wait and see until the judges tally up those final results. Up next, the Open Men's competitors hit the water for the extreme sport of jumping right here at the 2006 Barefoot Water Ski World Championships on Water Channel.
Hi, I'm Scott Pelleton with Sanger Boat Company, and today we're going to do a plant tour of the Sanger manufacturing facility to let you know just exactly how Sanger differs from the rest of the boat companies out there in the world. Sanger Boat Manufacturing has been in business since 1954. We've been in this factory for the last, 50 years. It's one of the largest manufacturing factories in the West Coast. Even though we only build 400 boats a year. We have 8 acres here, buildings on both sides. We've got lamination and gel coat on this side and rigging and upholstery and assembly on this side. So we're gonna go in and we're gonna start the process with gel coat, and then we'll move into lamination and into rigging and upholstery just to show you how Sanger boats are built. Let's go. Now you can pull the boat out of the mold and the gel coat separates from the mold itself. The problem with building gel coated boats is that you never know what you have until you have a whole boat. So when you talk about building weird colors and strange things, it's sometimes very difficult for somebody to know whether it's going to work until you have a boat. This is the way they come out of the mold. As you notice, it's got a beautiful luster on it. That has to do with the way the molds are built, the way they're maintained. We don't have to buff on this boat. That boat is right, looks like it could go onto the showroom floor right now, and you just watch them pull it out of that mold. Very few boat companies can pull a boat out of the mold and have it look like this boat looks, and that's one of the differences between a boat company like Sanger that doesn't build as many units, that have the time to maintain our molds, to take care of them. And you can only get so many boats out of mold. But this is beautiful, and that just came straight out of the deal. This is an example also of custom colors that we have. You know, this is an orange sidewall boat with two shades of blue. I mean, very, very few companies give you the opportunity to build the boat you need for your own purposes, whether it's you're trying to match a boat or what you're trying to do. This is the benefit to a Sanger Boat Company.
Give you an idea of what the competitors here at the 2006 Barefoot Water Ski World Championships are seeing as they approach that jump at 40 plus miles per hour. The Open Men's Jump lineup: William Brazoza, Lane Bauer, Andre DeVilliers, Brett New, and David Small. Up first, William Prezosa from the United States. His best jump so far, 23.8 meters.
Heather, he's nicknamed the Beast of the East. He's from Rhode Island. He's skiing for Team USA. Now watch as he powers himself out into that flat water and gets full extension. A very nice jump. Bill Brazoza skis, lands very smooth. He likes it.
23.6 meters for him. Up now, Lane Bowers, also from the United States of America. Very strong jumping from these guys. His best, a 25.1.
Well, Heather, I really enjoy watching Lane Bowers jump. He's probably got one of the smoothest styles in barefoot water skiing. Watch how Lane keeps his shoulders back, slides his feet to the top, and a really smooth, almost lands feet to feet most of the time, Lane Bowers from Team USA.
24 meters and a very smooth run. Up next, Andre de Villiers of the Republic of South Africa. His best jump so far, a 25.2.
Watch for Andre de Villiers. Watch for his feet to slide all the way to the top of the jump, his shoulders back, and that will give him the full extension upright. And he does just that, a great jump for Andre de Villiers. Tumbles a little bit, but the judges probably will award him that jump as being good.
25 meters for Andre. Brett New up from Australia. Very interesting form of jumping from this guy here. A 25.2, his best so far.
Well, watch Brett New. He's got a different style than everyone else. Watch as he comes into the ramp. He'll remove his right hand from the handle and jump. His body will go completely sideways as his feet behind his head. There it is right there. Lands completely smooth. A very long jump, Brett New, Australia.
Very exciting, and a 23.8. David Small now, the defending world champion from Great Britain. He has had a best of 26.3 meters.
26.3 meters in this competition, but he is the world record holder in this event. 27.4 meters is the world record. Will he break that right here today? It's a strong approach. There it is. A very big jump. He's out by that 27-meter ball. Is it enough, Heather?
A 26.4. Close, but it is the best score we've seen so far.
Well, it's not enough for the world record, but it is enough to win the gold medal. Timo Harju from Team Finland comes up and gives him a hug, Heather.
The running order for the Open Men's Slalom Division, Don Baker, Heinrich Sam, William Prezosa, Lane Bauer, and Keith St. Ives.
If you stay calm and just go do it, you'll do much better than stretching.
Don Baker of Canada up on the water right now. 18 was his first round score and a 17.7 in round two.
Heather, Don Baker from Team Canada. I've been impressed all week watching the Canadians, how good of technical skills they have at barefoot water skiing. Now we see this time start for Don Baker. He goes across, he's doing his front pass here, all very high, very clean, picks up early, sets down late, just what the judges want to see. This is Don Baker from Canada, and he's going to be finishing up with his run right there. Don Baker, very good run.
17.3 in round three. And Heinrich Sam from the Republic of South Africa on the water now. 15.7 was his round one score and an 18 in round two.
Heinrich, very good at the slalom event. We saw him dominate the junior boys division. He's the overall world champion in the junior boys. Now let's see what he can do with the big boys in the open men's division. Heinrich Sam, a very fast pace. Skiing on the ragged edge there, almost touching down early, but I think the judges will give him credit. Let's see what Heinrich Sam has to say as time expires for Heinrich's run.
17.5. William Prezosa of the United States of America on the water now. 18.2 was his score from round one, and an 18.4 in round two.
William Prezosa having a great tournament here at the 2006 World Barefoot Water Ski Championships. We saw him in the finals of the jump division. Now we see him in the slalom division. I saw his preliminary rounds and he skied very, very well. Now look at the pace he's got on his front pass. Bill Prezosa, he's from Rhode Island. He's the Beast of the East. Bill Prezosa, he's out and he's got a turn back on that last pass. Bill Prezosa from USA.
An 18.4 is his final score. Lane Bowers of the United States seated second in this open men's slalom division. 19 was his score in both rounds one and two.
Lane elects to come into the course on his first pass backwards. Lane is one of the most proficient backwards barefoot water skiers in the industry. Now watch as Lane transitions through the wake. See how he guides his foot around, makes a quick transition. He's right there across the wake again. He's got a very fast pace. He can ski up somewhere in the neighborhood of 11 back crossings as time expires. That's Lane Bowers from the United States of America.
Earning a score of 18.8 here in round three. That puts Lane at the top of the standings right now. But up next, we have Keith St. Ange. He's going to have to best that 18.8. Mike, what's he going to have to do?
Well, Keith St. Ange is the world record holder in this event. If anybody can best that score, it certainly will be Keith St. Ange. He pops the rope, gets the handle ready. He's very, very fast at these front slalom crossings. The world record is 20.6. Now we'll see what Keith St. Ange can do. Watch how he turns his knees in, keeps his shoulders nice and level, and turns that foot and gets a pull across that wake. See how fast he goes across that wake with his feet high and clean, his backside very low. Time expires. Keith St. Ange, I think he's done it there, Heather.
Score of 20.3. Some wakeboarding entertainment here while we get the Open Men's Trick Division ready to go out on the water on Water Channel from the 2006 Barefoot Water Ski World Championships. Welcome back to the 2006 Barefoot Water Ski World Championships from Adna, Washington. Here on the Water Channel, we're ready for the Open Men's Trick Event. Top five in the Open Men's Trick Division, Paul McDonald, Andre DeVilliers, Patrick Vayner, David Small, and top seed, Keith St. Ange. First on the water from Canada, it's Paul McDonald. Round one score saw 6,100 and 7,960 from round two.
Paul McDonald, a great guy. He's got a very magnetic personality. On the shore, a lot of water skiers hang out with this guy. Team Canada surrounds him. Now he's on the water. He's also known to be a very good coach. He's got a water ski school down in Winter Haven, Florida. He's a great coach and also a great skier. As we see him doing the 360-degree turns, the back-to-backs, the front-to-front 360s, he finishes up his run. It's a great pass for Paul McDonald.
Scores him a 77-10 here in round three. On the water now, Andre DeVilliers of the Republic of South Africa. 81-30 was his score in the first round and 82-30 in round two.
Watch how Andre skis. He's got a very, very smooth style. It almost seems like it's really effortless. It almost seems like he's standing on the concrete, not standing on the water. Now watch as he'll go into his toe turns. Very effortless, nice and smooth, reverse, all feet to feet. But no, sits that one down a little bit, Heather. Has a little problem there. Goes right into the line turns. Now the reverse line turn. Now watch, we'll see the line. Oh, the 1 foot back, the 1 foot front, the reverse 1 foot back, 1 foot front. Very good skiing from Andre DeVilliers.
Earned him a 59.80. Up now, Patrick Vayner of France. He's been barefooting since he was 8 years old, and in round one, he earned an 81.80. Round two saw him with an 88.50. Mike, what can we expect to see from him in this round?
Well, this is the first time I've got to meet Patrick Vayner since the junior, senior, and the open elite skiing is together. I've been very impressed with his skiing throughout the week. Now we see him on the water. Again, skiing very clean, very smooth, everything nice and calm. His access is very good. All his turns feet to feet. Now he goes right into the flips, skiing very well. As time expires, he's happy, shows us a fist. Great skiing.
68.50, the final points for Patrick. Out of the three skiers we've already seen, that puts him second in the current standings. Up now, defending world champion David Small earned a round one score of 97.30, 72.80 in round two, hoping to do better here in round three, Mike.
Not only the world champion from the previous year's skiing, but he is the world record holder in the jump event. Now watch as he loads up his toe hold, toe back, toe front. Now he goes to the reverse, toe back, toe front, comes off axis a little bit, but no problem there. Does the line 360, a great maneuver, falls out of the reverse line three, but regains composure as time runs out. David Small from Great Britain.
Still scored him a 91.80. He is at the top of the standing, but we still have Keith St. Ange representing the United States, a round one score of 10,500 and round two, 10,850.
Both of those scores, new pending world records. The world record set by Andre DeVilliers at 97.30, now Keith on the water. I've had the opportunity to ski with him for the last few years, being sponsored by barefootcentral.com. Keith St. Ange has just been skiing fantastically. Look how clean and smooth his toe turns are. Now the 1 foot turns, the reverse 1 foot turns, the 360s very, very fast. Two front to front 360s, a side to side. Keith St. Ange is extremely happy because I think he's just set another pending world record.
He matched that round two score of 10,850 points. Now that the competition's all wrapped up, Banana George Blair takes on the water here at Lake Silverado. We'll be back with the final scores and interviews right here on Water Channel.
old gel coat graphics. So what we mean by that is we actually spray gel coat in these graphics. This is not tape. This is metallic gel coat in the trim colors and gel coat in every other spot. The only things that are stickers are the nameplates, the model insignia, the motor insignia, the Wake Series, and the Sanger insignia. You have the option of getting deck colors and bottom colors. They can be all the same color. They can be different colors. This is a dagger graphic. You can have a V graphic. There's checkerboard. There's waves. We have about six different graphics packages, all with in-mold gel coat.
After such amazing competition, the judges have finally tallied up the final scores. 13.5 points puts Narissa Wright at the top of the open women's slalom standings. Rachel Normand in second with 13.1. Ashley Stebbings and Emily Goldie tie for third. Sitting atop the open men's slalom standings is Keith St. Ange with a 20.3. Second place, Lane Bowers with an 18.8, and William Brazoza in third with 18.4.
I've been doing this for 18 years now, since I was 10 years old, so it's kind of, it's in my blood. Just love it. It's what I enjoy, and I just got to try to keep it going for as long as I can.
On the top of the podium once again, Jody Sherwood, this time for the Open Women's Trick Division, 2,350 points. Rachel Norman and Laura Swede in second and third with 2,170.
It's probably my best event, and it's what I train the hardest for, so it felt really good.
Keith St. Ange takes the gold in the Open Men's Trick Division with a pending world record of 10,850 points. David Small in second with a 9,180, and Paul McDonald in third with 7,710.
I came here actually with the focus of getting the overall, because I'd never have won the overall before, and I won it this time around, and it was due to, you know, the slalom and tricks.
Let's take a look back at both passes of that pending world record run.
All right, watch how clean Keith skis. He goes right into the toe turns, toe back, toe front, great access, shoulders nice and level, 1 foot back, 1 foot front, reverse 1 foot back, 1 foot front, 360 front to front, reverse 360 front to front, and a side slide. He'll show his hands, he's happy with the first pass. As he comes into the course for his second pass, watch Keith St. Ange as he sets up. Time will start when he does that first trick. There's a front to back five, now a back to back seven, big points there. A back-to-back three, a back-to-front five, now a line 360 and more big points. Line back, line front, line back, line front, the reverse. He falls at the end of the run. Keith St. Ange with his hand high in the air. He knows that he's just set a new pending world record, 10,850 points.
Receiving the gold medal from Banana George Blair, it's Rachel Norman with a best jump of 13.5 meters. Ashley Stebbings in second with a 12.5, and Emily Goldie 11.8 meters to take third.
Man, it's just a dream kind of come true, and I'm just so excited to be here and doing my best. I set a personal best for myself in the jump event, and that was really exciting for me.
Taking the gold back to Great Britain for the jump event, it's David Small with a 26.4 meter jump. Andre Davilias with a strong second place and 25 meters. Lane Bowers in third with a 24 meter jump.
Amazing. We had perfect conditions all week. The competition was good. Everyone skied well. So we're happy with our performance. We got team third as well, which was nice.
It's no easy task to be crowned the overall champion here at the Barefoot Worlds, but Rachel Norman took it with 3,000 points.
I know Rachel's been training extremely hard for this event. Now she's standing at the top of the podium. She's done it. She's your world champion.
To me, it feels like I'm flying, and I love that feeling. So you just go fast, and you're gliding over the water, and it's just something that's like a miracle every time you're up there.
Keith St. Ange takes the men's overall championship at this year's Worlds with 2,878 points.
I've known Keith for a long time. He's a very good friend of mine. He wanted this worse than anybody, and he went out and took it. Keith St. Ange, your world champion.
It means quite a bit because last Worlds, I didn't win, and the guy that beat me is actually here coaching another team, so I wish he was here to compete against me.
Heather, what we haven't talked about is the team division. Each country picks four or five skiers from their country to ski on their team, and then we have a team division, and the results from that are what?
Republic of South Africa, very strong showing in the junior division. They take that. United States takes the senior and open divisions. What an amazing weekend of competition.
It has been an amazing weekend. We've seen several personal bests. We've got to see a world record from Keith St. Ange. It's just been very, very exciting to be here.
On behalf of myself, Heather Adams, my partner, Mike Salber, and our entire Water Channel crew, thank you for joining us. We'll see you next time on the water right here on television's new wave, Water Channel.
Inside the Bay, brought to you by Bay of Quenty Tourism.
What do you say to people who are looking at this for the first time, wondering what it is, wondering how to get involved, wondering how difficult it is?
Not difficult, especially when people start at a younger age. Becky started when she was 5 years old,
yeah.
And it's like she has just grown with it. And even at the cottage on the weekend, we had a couple of neighbors come by from the lake, yeah. and we'd like to try that. Tuck them out on the boom, and 5 minutes later, they're up on their feet
okay.
on the boom.
So you can make it happen in a day.
We can make it happen. Like, if you want a barefoot, it can happen.
Will there be opportunities leading into 2018 to have, you know, people from the general public who might be interested to come out and try it?
We would be more than happy to.
Cool.
Everywhere we go, we're constantly telling people, if you want to try it, you just get a hold of us,
okay.
and we'll make it happen.